Welcome to A Daily Encounter with Christ, meditations from the readings of the Divine Liturgy. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to the Holy Apostle and Evangelist Luke. Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you. Let us be attentive. The Lord told this parable. There was a man who had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, "Father, give me the share of property that falls to me." And he divided his living between them. Not many days later, the younger son gathered all that he had, and he took his journey into a far country, and there he squandered his property in loose living. And when he had spent everything, a great famine arose in that country, and he began to be in want. So he went and joined himself to one of the citizens of that country, who sent him into his fields to feed swine. And he would gladly have fed on the pods that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself, he said, "How many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare, but I perish here with hunger? I will arise and go to my father, and I will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Treat me as one of your hired servants.' And he arose and came to his father, but while he was yet at a distance, his father saw him and had compassion, and ran and embraced him and kissed him. And the son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to his servants, 'Bring quickly the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet, and bring the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and make merry. For this my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found.' And they began to make merry. Now his elder son was in the field, and as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing, and he called one of the servants and asked what this meant. And he said to him, 'Your brother has come, and your father has killed the fatted calf, because he has received him safe and sound.' But he was angry and refused to go in. His father came out and entreated him, but he answered his father, 'Behold, these many years I have served you, and I have never disobeyed your command. Yet you never gave me so much as a kid goat that I might make merry with my friends. But when this son of yours came, who has devoured your living with harlots, you killed for him the fatted calf.' And he said to him, 'Son, you are always with me, and all that is mine is yours. It was fitting to make merry and be glad, for this your brother was dead and is alive. He was lost and is found.' Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you." Today is a unique Sunday in the Church's year, insofar as we are celebrating both the Sunday of the Prodigal Son and the afterfeast of the encounter with the Lord Jesus in the temple by the holy prophet Simeon and the righteous prophetess Anna. Now, on the surface, both of these stories seem to be speaking of completely different themes. The story of the encounter with the Lord in the temple, which we celebrated yesterday, reminds us of our Lord Jesus being brought into the temple by his parents, Joseph and Mary, for the first time some 40 days after his holy birth, to be consecrated to the Lord, offering the sacrifice of two pigeons, since they could not afford a lamb, in fulfillment of the law. There they met the elderly priest, prophet, and doctor of the law, Simeon, and the elderly prophetess, Anna, both who prophesy extraordinary things concerning the child, how he is to be the salvation of the world and a light to the nations, and the glory of God's people Israel, and how he is to suffer the passion, and his holy mother the compassion, where her own heart will be pierced. The other story is a parable told by Jesus of a father with two sons. The father is a very wealthy man, and one of his sons decides to take his inheritance early, before the death of his father, to go to a faraway place and spend it on the pleasures of this world. When a famine comes to the land, however, all of his so-called friends on whom he spent all of his money abandon him, and he is reduced to working with pigs, an unclean animal in Jewish tradition. He is brought so low that he is even envious of the pigs and their food, these husks that he feeds them. But the memory of home and his father comes to mind, and he returns to his house to present himself to his father, but not as a son, rather as a hired servant. Jesus relates that even while he was afar off, though, his father saw his son, and he was moved with pity and love for him, and ran to meet him on the way, something that would have seemed undignified for a wealthy and elderly man to do in Jewish culture. On the road, the son falls to his knees and begs his father to receive him as a lowly servant, but the father will hear none of it. He embraces his son, who likely smells like the pigs that he had served for so long, and directs his servants to bring the finest robe and put it upon him, take rings and put them on his fingers and shoes on his feet, and to kill the fatted calf in celebration. The elder son, the brother who stayed behind, resents his father's generosity towards his wayward brother and complains. But the father reminds him that he should also be rejoicing in the restoration of his brother. All of the inheritance that he has is his, but the greater treasure, his brother, has been given back to him. The treasure that was lost to them has been found. He who was dead spiritually and socially to them has been brought back to life. So what can we then say about these two stories? One, an account of an event early in our Lord's life, and the other a parable that he tells during his teaching ministry some 30 years later. What connection can we make between these stories? First, these stories speak to us of a life-changing encounter with the Lord. For Anna and Simeon, they encounter the Lord in the temple. But in the story of the prodigal son, the father is a symbol for the Lord Jesus, and the prodigal son encounters the Lord on the road back to his house. But in both stories, they encounter the Lord and their lives are changed forever. They can neither forget nor be indifferent to this experience of encountering the Lord. Secondly, both of these stories reveal to us two distinct kinds of hope. Hope, we say, is the grace of God that, in the face of circumstances that seem desperate or difficult, believes that he will still set all things aright. For Anna and Simeon, this encounter with the Lord is the fulfillment of the hope of the righteous. They have lived their lives as saints, as holy ones of God, faithfully praying in the temple for many years. Now the hope of these two righteous elders is fulfilled in their midst in the presence of a tiny child. Their hope is the hope of the restoration of God's people and the hope of the ultimate destruction of death's power. Simeon even prayed that he might be spared death until he saw the Messiah, the Savior of Israel. God fulfilled this hope for him. Both his and Anna's hope was for one that went beyond the grave, for both themselves and their people, that they might finally depart in peace after so long a travail upon the earth. Theirs is the hope of the righteous that goes beyond the grave, and no doubt would be fulfilled before the eyes of Simeon and Anna in the mystery of Holy Saturday, when Jesus would burst through the gates of Hades to claim the righteous. There, Simeon and Anna, long since passed away some 30 years earlier, would encounter not a lowly infant, but a victorious king and Lord who had conquered death and bore the signs of his victory in his hands and his feet and his side. Their eyes would see the fulfillment of this hope of mankind in this infant turned into a victorious Savior. But if for Anna and Simeon we see the hope of the righteous, for the prodigal son we see a different experience of hope, the hope of sinners. The son returns to the father's house, and he comes with a desperate hope of a hired servant. He has only known the friendship of those who would use him and then abandon him in his hour of greatest need. He is fearful and ashamed. His hope is that of one who has nearly lost all hope in others and for himself. He has been humiliated and dejected and realizes and is ready to admit his sin and unworthiness before his father. But we see in the response of the father a compassion beyond all hope. We see in this encounter with the Lord a love that does not simply care for the needs of the body, but one that reaches out with the compassion of a loving father to restore a son to his original dignity. If in the story of Anna and Simeon we see that love is stronger than death, then in the story of the prodigal we see that love is also stronger than sin. And this is the message of today. This is indeed the message of the whole gospel. Christ comes as both the hope of the righteous and the hope of sinners. So as we prepare for the great fast, we must be willing to encounter him in the sacraments, in the church, in prayer, in works of mercy towards our neighbor, in sacrifice and in confession. We must be willing to be like the prodigal and to be humble and to humble ourselves before our Heavenly Father. But we must also be willing to be like the righteous Anna and Simeon and to share in the hope that goes beyond ourselves for the salvation of all generations and all peoples. Through these means, we will be prepared to encounter the Lord in the resurrection and see once again in our own lives and in the lives of others that in Christ's love we see a power stronger than death and indeed stronger than sin itself. Glory to Jesus Christ. glory forever.